like a spoon.
Exactly. You know,
made out of
pieces. This is this. This is food. This is food. Food and
I let you notice that everyone.
Exactly.
Please come to the door, please. Please, I have this for you, please.
Hello. So today, I took Nandi and Kize to a restaurant in Ghana. She recently moved from the UK to Ghana, but she's a South African, and I took her somewhere to try for the first time Banku and Okro stew. So without much talking, she's a content creator too, so please don't forget, I'll put her link below the description. Click on it and subscribe to her channel. And don't forget to subscribe to my too and like the video and share. Her first time trying Banku in Ghana. Let's go.
No. Like, we can talk normally. Just a chat.
One of the reasons why I came to Ghana is the weather.
I
really love it.
We have summer, I think, throughout the year.
Because right now, what is this period? It's like a dry period, right?
It's not even the dry. Okay, it is the dry period. That's from, I think, January.
Mm-hmm.
January coming to February, thereabouts. That's the Hamatana.
That's it. I hear that everywhere and everyone's like, your lips get dry.
Yeah.
From like dry wear or so hot.
That's why we have this thing here, shea butter.
Mm-hmm.
So you can use the shea butter, yes.
That's basically what I use now. Okay. From the market.
Mostly that's, they do it in the northern region.
Mm-hmm.
That's where they come to
the shea butter
comes from. Sister Laos, I've forgotten the place, but I think mostly so many towns in the northern region
come from there.
Because that's the only place you can grow this share nut.
Mm-hmm. It's out there,
You can also grow it here.
Mm-hmm. Where are you from? Are you from the
Accra? I am from the central region.
Okay.
I am from the central region. That's, okay, there are so many like places, but the capital is Cape Coast. Or the central region of Cape Coast.
That's the central region?
The central region, yeah.
Central.
The same
like
thing.
There's no L.
There is L. Central.
Oh, it's central. Okay,
central.
Fine. Central.
That's how we pronounce it. Central region.
Okay.
Central
and
region is the capital.
That's where you're from.
I'm not from Cape Coast. I'm from Winneba.
Winneba.
I went to Winneba.
Yeah. I've never been, but I drove through it. Yeah. And my friend who's here was like saying,
junction.
I want to go to Winneba.
That's the junction. That's like where you drive fast.
Right.
Like you drove fast.
Yeah.
That's called Winneba Junction. The town actually is inside.
It goes a little further in. I see. And you're from there. Okay. So how long have you been in Accra
for? Not for a very long time. I'm not even like permanently staying here right now, but I'm trying to move.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say within this year, definitely.
Within this year, you want to move?
When I can. Because when you are here, and most of the work that I do, most of my clients, they are here. So
there.
Why should I stay there?
And then keep coming back.
Even
this is why you want to train.
So that's.
You're living proof.
Because. Renting a property.
Yeah.
Very expensive.
And you have to do it for like such a long period of time. Like, I don't know how anyone does can afford that.
The law says 6 months.
The law is 6 months.
But the people or the landlords are not agreeing to that. Because perhaps they feel, some of them, that's the only thing they do. So they feel giving them 6 months is like a chicken change.
So is that why the landlords were longer?
Yeah, so it is the landlord and the landlady who are giving this like rent to people 2 years, 1 year, 2 years. But when you go to these, I think this may go on in some places. And for them, they do the 6 months thing. But when you go to the local areas, would say 2 years.
Why is that?
You went and you're getting that amount of
money. I wouldn't even be able to afford that. So how anyone does?
A Ghanaian supermarket. That's why some, like recently there were some videos around like circulating Ghanaians abroad. They were like, hey, when you are living in Ghana and you are able to live here for the rest of your life, then you are the real G. Like you really try, because living abroad, they have seen that most of the stuff that they use is on credit.
Yeah, it's true.
In Ghana, when you see someone using an iPhone 11, iPhone 12, in a way, I think it is better because
it's less debt.
It is for you. No one will come and say this is for me. But in another way, too, it brings you. For this brain thing that we have talked about, I'm moving from let's say 1,000 or one place to the other, and I'm supposed to rent. And the landlord is saying 2 years. No matter how long, like any way that I will get the money, I have to
find a way.
You
know
what I mean? So,
and then once you pay this, right, you don't have to pay for that for the next 2 years.
You are not going to pay for the next 2 years.
Yeah.
So, because you've already paid.
Thank you. Okay, you have to teach me how to do it. I literally did it one time, so I can't.
And how did you do it?
So I had to go like this or like this, and then you go.
Why? Like, did you go with someone or?
Yeah, I went with my friend who took me.
Okay,
so this is
okay, so this is the okro soup.
It smells, it's got fish.
Yeah,
right?
They have fish, they have meat, and this is crab.
And this is crab, okay.
Crab, yes.
I tried the crab last time and I eat it with the shell. Wow. God, I feel so poor.
So this is what I got for myself. Fufu and goat meat. This is goat meat and tilapia.
Oh, and tilapia.
Yes, tilapia. That's what I got for myself. So.
But I've never had this before, guys. God, it's gonna be filming.
She says she's never had this.
No,
before, so,
I've never had this one before.
Yeah, so she's going to try for the first time. Mm-hmm. Let's see how it goes.
Don't laugh at my eating skills.
Yeah.
Thank you. So you have to teach me how to do the cleaning, right?
Okay, this is also.
What do I do?
You just use the liquid
soap. Mm-hmm. Let me watch you. What do you do?
I want to wash my. Okay, no problem. Like what I would do is I would just pour a little of this.
Like that? Okay, I'll do it.
Because in Ghana, in Africa, we eat with our hands.
Yes, you do.
We almost everybody, mm-hmm. they eat with their hands. So, when you go to every household, this is what you are going to see.
So this is what you do?
Yeah, this is what you are going to see. People eating with their hands, it's a normal thing. Yeah.
Your hands, I think, I don't like this.
Yeah, all you have to do, you are just trying to... So I'm just trying to take out all the toys from it. So that's what you are doing. Try to take all the toys out of it. From your mind. Let me apply this one a bit because the soap has, yes. Yeah, like the soap has taken over the that was the name. The water soap. That's awesome.
Okay. It's basically washing your hands.
Yeah, basically washing your hands. oxygen, and hot water helps a lot.
I see. And here in Accra, my hands always dirty.
Definitely, there will be some dirt around your around your hands, so like part of the environment.
So why have I got this separate now?
Like which one? This thing?
Yeah. No. This and this. What's this?
That's for the bones.
Oh, that's for the bones.
That's for the bones. So when you eat and you have any bones, something that you don't want to speak in, you can just
drop. Okay, fine. I will do that then.
So that's how it is.
So then you eat with your right hand, right?
Yes, you eat with your right hand. And you just unwrap it.
I can use my
just
left hand.
Yeah.
Last time I just thought...
Even eating, you can eat with your left hand because now we are in a, like, I'll say the modern world.
Okay.
It is the olden days that people were like worried about people eating with their left hand, because most of the people that we have in Ghana, when they go to the loo, usually they use their
left hand.
Exactly. So when anyone sees you that you are doing this, eating with your right hand, like your left hand, they feel you are rather eating with your left hand.
I was also told we were going to look
at us now. And even greeting people.
Huh?
And even greeting people. Greeting elders.
Yeah, I thought like if you hand money over, everything.
With
like,
your left hand and all
that. Yeah, because I started doing that. My Ghanaian friend was like, no. You can't do that. So then I go.
Yes.
So I've done mine.
You just...
Okay, this is all mine. I can't.
They
give you too much.
Just use your hand just to cut a bit.
Right.
Yeah.
And then I go.
How does it feel?
It feels sticky.
And
and like gloopy. But it feels like is it maize?
It's maize.
Yeah. So it feels like maize.
And cassava.
Oh, it's cassava. Yes. And
cassava
dough
and maize, like fondo. It's like fondo. We call it fondo. Because of the soup. For the pupu, you see how we cut it? It is a our two fingers. We just cut.
Oh, okay.
Just
that's
two fingers. We just cut. Yeah. That's it. And you make a hole.
Mm-hmm.
And you just do it.
Oh, so it's like a spoon.
Exactly. You know,
made out of pieces.
This is ten. This is two. This is four. Four and ten.
So why do they not chew?
Because of the soup. If you try to chew it, because it don't, like, it's already
mine. It's supposed to just go down.
Just go down, that's it.
So
most of our
food is almost like comfort food, like.
Yeah. It's what our food here, like that's our food. I think bamboo. Yeah, it's something called Kunti. Sorry. Nice, very good.
So, the meat is just burning in my finger. Yeah, I think I'm really slow at eating.
Yeah, because it's the first, like, first or second time you're talking that way. But you get used to it. When you keep on eating, you get used to it. Living here, definitely you need to try the food once in a while.
And then I just get used to it. So this generally is it's very different from any food I've had in South Africa.
Oh my God,
what is it even called? I'm going to embarrass myself now. I'm trying to remember. But if you use it, it's very similar, like name.
Similar, yeah.
So I'm used to that. We have it with like oxtail. I think that's like a family recipe.
Yeah.
So I'm used to that and that thing. A bit similar.
Oh,
wait,
it's just similar. And what's the name?
I literally can't remember. I will remember and tell them and then they'll
come. Okay. It's normal because, like, children to start their stage of learning how to eat and eat properly.
Exactly, that's how I feel. That's what I'm doing. Why do I mash it like this?
You can even decide not to do it.
Why do I need to do that?
Exactly, because it has already been used.
Okay, fine. Get all the pieces
because there are lots of fishes of head, like meat inside, crab, meat, the fish, so there's more space. And you can just put that crab on top of the other one and get more space. Yeah,
I see.
Yeah.
So this I'm supposed to literally like eat whole, right?
You can eat it like anyhow that you want to eat it. It's yours, so
I you can decide. I feel bad eating with my left hand.
some people just eat everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, like some people eat, like don't eat everything. You just eat some parts.
Okay. So I can do what I do.
Yes.
It's my food. Yeah, I feel like that food has been like a big culture shock, I think. Main one.
Like food and what? Like what again? Food and what again?
Food and...
Like the culture shock that you had in the first. Food and what again?
I just feel like everything is different.
Everything?
Like everything is different. Just, I've even changed my walk. Everything is...
Different.
Everything is different. Like just the pace of life is slower. It's a little slower, but that's actually one of the reasons why I came. Because I felt like London life and life in the West is so stressful.
Ghanaians are very cool.
That's what I've noticed. I've noticed. Like in London, it's like go, go, go. You have to go from this place to this place to this place. Like, you don't say hi, you don't smile.
If you don't go, who's going to stay away?
If you go?
If you don't move, who's going to stay
away? Well, yeah, you have that.
That's why most times, like many people are trying to move here because it's too stressful.
Yeah.
People up there, like people abroad, it's too stressful.
It's too stressful. It's honestly way too stressful. And it's just like a quality of life that I don't really think people are genuinely happy. I think people are just going from one day to the next, one day to the next, but not actually enjoying
just
and being present.
Like trying to survive.
Yeah, just trying to survive. And I think it's very like career driven. But I guess you have that here, but I don't know. I just found it all a bit too stressful.
It is actually very, 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 very stressful.
Very stressful. So this. Like the blue is the thing, right? This is like the fish that's in the market, right?
Yeah, we have a tuna.
It's tuna.
Tuna, yeah. And this is tilapia. This sort of fish is tilapia.
Oh, I love tilapia.
I love tilapia.
It's nice. Because it's like meaty.
Yeah.
It's the pepper. Another thing I think I've noticed, and people told me about the people in Ghana being like very friendly, but I've actually just been like amazed by how friendly people are here. Like it's very, everyone's very welcoming and smiling, like it's nice.
It's part of the culture. Mm-hmm. Every Ghanaian child, let's say in the olden days, not even now, when there are so many families in your area, mm-hmm. and you are a child, it's actually, like Barry said, it's actually an insult mm-hmm. to even see an elderly and just pass by.
Really? Oh, I love that. Thank you. So, you're supposed to say hi, like...
Greetings. Good morning, good afternoon. Mm-hmm. We have our local greetings. Marching, mama, all that. Mm-hmm. So, at least say something.
At least say something. You can't say, okay, this is good to know. I have to remember this.
So, that's also fun. Mm-hmm. That's why I met, like, so many Ghanaians. You see them.
That's why it's like,
that
since
is
I think
seen.
The culture is like, respectful. Exactly.
I can be speaking and I cannot say about 10 sentences without saying please.
I literally noticed that. Everyone,
exactly.
Please come to the door, please. Mm. Please, I have this for you, please. Why is that?
It's the culture. Mm. That's how Ghanaian children were brought up.
It's manners. Manners. You have manners here. I like it. I still feel like I'm doing this so wrong.
You are trying. You're actually trying. You're actually trying.
I'm a trier. I don't know if I'm going to try this one. This is like a cow or whatever.
Yeah, it is a cow. And that's a cow skin. Yeah, that I was talking about. We call it willy. It is willy.
Willy.
It is tasteless, but people love it. I don't know why. It doesn't also give any nutrients, but people just love it.
It's a texture.
I think you can find it in mostly in West Africa. Mostly in West Africa.
Is it the first?
That was like our skin itself.
That was the skin.
Yeah. When they take out and light it up, the hair from this like it out, and they dry it, and they take the hair out. You know that my water inside is under
As soon as you hear the water, I feel like it's just gonna like squirt into my mouth. That is awesome. You see, there are cultural differences that you have to.
Yeah. It will take time, I know, but gradually you get.
I think actually I've done better than I did with the first one.
The first one, yeah. So gradually.
I think I'm
done. Yeah, better.
I think I'm done.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
You see?
I think I'm done.
You are done, no problem.
That's okay. So now what do I do?
You just
wash it again.
Wash it again. So,
actually very
cold. It's alright, I'll just pour some of this water. Because you also need it.
It's nice, actually. I like the feeling of
eating
with my hands.
Yeah.
That's a natural.
Yeah.
This is how humans have always been.
In Ghana? I feel, I feel, but those days are all the beginning of the world. I'm not sure people had like food. So definitely people were eating with your hands. People were just eating with your hands, but I don't know why people are just trying to.
Even fufu sometimes.
Oh, people have been eating with
them. Fufu is one thing that you are not supposed to even eat with your hands, like with a spoon. But nowadays, you see one of these people, like,
doing that,
like,
it's not like, what are you doing? This is rude. Don't disrespect the food you like.
Exactly. You are not respecting the culture.
No.
You couldn't finish it, so I'm showing it to them.
I have no friends. I couldn't finish it.
So when you look at my food, just look at mine. It's done. And let's go to Nandi's food. Just look at the Banku. They gave her two. But she just finished half of just one. And when you look at this soup,
oh my god, stop it, you make me feel bad.
But I feel she tried.
I tried.
She really tried, because this is like her first time eating in a place like this. Mm-hmm. And she has actually done
I
well.
I tried. I think I did quite well.
If you think this is her first time eating this food and what she eats is okay, please just comment below.
They're gonna be like, go back to the UK. She doesn't belong in Ghana.
Exactly. But I know gradually she will get used to it. Yeah, she will definitely get used to it.
We should do like a year's program, or maybe.
Yeah, definitely. So we basically came to head to Chopa to eat. And this was her first time trying Banku. And I'm very sure you saw how she ate the food and how much she ate. Very small. But
stop trying to shame me.
I know that.
Okay, I did well after it.
But I know that definitely she's here in Ghana, so definitely with time she will get used to the food that we have around. Mm-hmm. Banku, fufu and all the other food. So
I will.
I don't know whether you have something to tell my people. Okay.
I don't know.
One thing that I want to say is she's a content creator, so please don't forget, I will put her link in my description.
Mm-hmm.
Please follow and do what? Subscribe to her channel, please.
Yes, please.
Follow and subscribe to her channel, because she's actually here, so she'll be sharing more of her experiences living in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
On her channel. So please go there and do what? Support her channel.
Thank you very much.
All right. Bye-bye. Don't forget to subscribe to mine too. Don't forget.
Yes.
Okay.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye.